to do.
I mean, I ain't going for it. I'm married. You know what I'm saying? But just, you know, like, bad enough to be a nigga, but wonderful. Like, I'm not going to get that to the world. I'm not going to feed my people that shit. Because that's some... Come on, man. You can't eat a fat ass.
Well, well some people could.
Angel. It ain't about that. It ain't about that. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you ain't talented, I'm not rocking with it.
There's definitely no nigga like him, yo.
Thank you, man. You know what I mean? Niggas don't know how to rap. Niggas crap. Crap,
like, yeah, a couple of niggas is trying to be like X, you know.
Yeah, I know.
You're coming out with this.
Copycatters.
I mean, that's the highest form of flattery. Imitation is the highest form of flattery.
Wow.
I mean, I appreciate it, but don't get to that side of bite, you know. Used to be my dog, it was in my left city.
So who was that for?
That was for John.
You and John cool now? Like,
no.
Nah.
Wow.
I don't hate him.
Yeah.
But you just not.
I don't fuck with him.
Exactly.
Right. You know, he never apologized like a man. Be a man about it. I can respect a mistake. I can respect, yo, I was wrong.
Right.
And then, this nigga, now, mind you, I'm gonna give it to you straight. I'm working on my joint, and I was doing an interview for somebody, for some magazine or something, and I said, yo, you know what? I said, yeah, that nigga getting a little too close, man. You know what I'm saying? I mean, he getting too close to my style, yo. I mean, yo, so you know what? I'm gonna fuck around and make a song called Ruled Out. It just came out right in there.
Wow.
Right? Yeah, so, yeah. 2 days later, this nigga goes back. He must have ran straight to Murder Inc. Like, he had to, dog. I mean, I was like, yo. Hey. So this nigga, I get back to the word back. This nigga, he responded to a song they ain't even made.
Wow.
I just threw a title in there. I said, yo, you know what I mean? You know,
crazy.
I make jokes sometimes. I'll fucking make a song called Ruled Out. And he ran with it. And then he ran with it. I'm like,
wow.
Oh, damn, you that scared of me, nigga?
Damn.
You didn't even hear the song? The song ain't even done, but you already responded to it? Like, you fucking bitch ass nigga, you know what I mean? So they let him get his shine on. He on the radio all crazy. I'm like, all right. I make the joint called War.
Whoa. Like, yeah, I remember that. Yeah, I remember that. That was crazy.
They gave it no burn. Right when I made my shit, it's like, let's squash the beef. Now you want to squash the beef, you fucking, you know what I mean? Now you want to. So, Pete. We had ends. We had odds, whatever. I mean, we don't fuck with each other, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
That shit I heard on the radio was fuck you, this and that, you know what I mean? That's what you fucking bitch ass nigga. Yeah. So.
Y'all won't park!
But don't get here. The nigga is little me. If you look at Survival of the Illest, I was the nigga with the bandana with the triangle on the side.
Yeah.
You mean? That was me. Now that's you. Okay, I respect you. You ain't had no tats on your back. You mean? I threw the joint in the back and rep with it. Now you got it. Okay. Like I said, invitation is the highest form of flattery. But we end up on it now. I'm not a morning person at all.
Right? I mean, he did call early in the morning.
I stayed at a motherfucking in a hotel at the airport on the way to Chicago. My nigga Kato. Nigga was a head of Latin Kings, yo. Head Latin King.
Wow.
I mean, top dog. You
that's
mean?
Crazy.
Every time I came to Chicago, so he had 10 trucks at the airport waiting for me.
Holy shit.
In fact, I got the truck he gave me downstairs.
Holy shit.
Silver,
a real nigga.
Ram, with, you know what I mean? For the dog DMX in the back, he put an X in the head rest, all that, man. That's my nigga, man.
Holy
Kato,
shit.
Rest in peace, man. Hey, yo, Kato!
That's crazy.
Peep, real talk, though. I'm at the airport, I'm at the counter, getting my ticket. Not a morning person at all. This nigga. Now, I see BJ and Gunner. Now, I ain't a nigga that's on some guilt by association type shit. Like, if I fuck with you,
yeah.
I fuck with you till you disrespect me. Even if I got beef with your man, nigga, I'ma still fuck with you because we
had a little relationship. Adults. Yeah,
I mean,
exactly.
Man, if you that small minded where you gotta ride with your man because I got beef with your man, then fuck it, I'll lay you down too. But I ain't gonna put it on you like that. I mean, so I'm talking to BJ, and, what's up, my nigga? Because we both sanitary, so I'm like, yeah, my nigga. Yeah. This nigga walks up. Yo, what's up, man? You ain't fucking with your man no more? You know that little cheesy smile you got, like, you ain't fucking with your man no more? And I hear the shit, I turn around, I'm like,
oh, shit.
Like, I'm already mad, because like I said, it's the morning. I'm like, nigga, you serious? Nah, nigga, I don't fuck with you no more. Yo, excuse my back, man. And then you just turn my back on again.
Wow.
Yo, if I was at the airport, I would just turn around and pound the fuck out. You get some bitch ass shit one day. I'm in the office all day, Bloodline. I'm doing a mixtape. That's when I gave out the war joint.
Oh, okay.
All day I'm in Def Jam, in my office, Bloodline. This nigga, I'm there with me, my wife, and my fucking son.
Holy
my baby, yo. This baby, my fucking 2-year-old.
Wow. Yeah,
my baby. So, soon as I leave, I bump into Gotti downstairs. I'm like, yo, Gotti, because Gotti was wrong. You know what I'm saying? He was like, nigga, you a producer.
supposed to calm shit down. Radio, yeah.
You know what I mean? Talking shit for a nigga. I'm your man. I'm your man, son.
That's crazy.
You
know what
I mean? Why is you sticking up? Your man can't hold his own weight. When me and Trigger, you know, was at ends, we had our battle. You just kept us at the studio several times. Even though we wasn't even on no violent shit. It was a rap battle.
Definitely.
But I saw how you already do when two of your mans got beef.
That's
now
crazy.
Now you're taking someone else. You getting caught up. I ain't fucking with you no more, nigga. I mean,
wow.
So, this nigga pops up at the office. Soon as I leave, he must have been waiting. X left. All right, come on, yo. Let's make this movie. Nigga's coming there like 30 deep. So they walk him over. Yo, where X at?
Where?
All right, tell nigga, don't come back. I'm like, oh, yeah. Friend, though. Because I left already. I was there all day. Like 8 o'clock. Soon as I leave, you come up. Like, you waiting for the call.
And you and your wife and your kids.
Yeah. So it's like,
what are they going to do with your wife and your kids?
Just a statement.
Like, come on, man.
But see, what he didn't know was I had that 30-shot motherfucking 9 on me. Beretta, so it's like.
The other baby.
Yeah. Soon as you would have peeked the door, I'd have hit you and whoever else in the doorway. Nigga,
30 of them.
Don't play.
Like
don't
I said,
play
don't.
Fans, don't
exactly.
Play. Don't. Yeah. I tell you.
That's what I said earlier.
I do my time. What you want from me? 8:30. Yeah, I'll come out to that. You mean it's not a problem? It's not a problem.
Yeah,
you
that's
mean?
Real,
so
see?
This bitch ass nigga. See that boy? Dude, you ain't fucking with your man no more.
That's crazy.
Nah, nigga, I don't fuck with you like that. Yo, excuse my back, yo. Even though I don't like it, I'm still respect. Excuse my back.
Wow.
That's business saying, fuck you, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Turn my back on nigga. You know what I'm saying? Get my ticket. Get on the plane. He copping out some addicts on the plane. I was asleep. I get on the plane, I sleep. My wife him. He's on some fucking Wall Street nigga on the plane. You know, like 50-year-old white dude. Like, yeah, you know what I mean? That other guy over there used to be whole, but you know, something. She hears all this shit. You know what I'm saying? So we get off the motherfucking plane now. Mind you, this is a successful rap nigga.
Wow.
Nobody takes a flight and don't have a ride. You mean that niggas take a flight? You have a ride waiting for you at the airport.
Exactly. Car
whether
service.
It's a car service.
Your boys.
You,
admit, or
you have a ride.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nobody hops on the Holiday Inn shuttle bus. Nobody, dog. I ain't never been on that joint. The Ramada shuttle bus. Nobody does that. Nobody.
Or even a cab. Just jump in the cab and wait there.
Hilarious right there.
I come out the motherfucking airport when I get Cato. 10 trucks.
Pow.
All Latin Kings.
Pow.
I mean, and we wasn't on no. Well, they did what they did. You whatever. You know what I'm saying? You know how it is.
Wow.
They did what they did. But I wasn't. You know what I'm saying? I come out and the kid was like, he's like, yo. I know I didn't just see what I think I saw. I was like, see, it would have been on my conscience. I can see nigga get popped. There's nothing. You earned that one, nigga. You asked. You paid for that bullet. You paid for that. Fuck you. That's putting out money. Fuck you. Suck my dick. You putting out money on that. You mean?
Yeah.
On that.
That's gangster right there.
Nigga say, yo, what's up? He won't leave the airport. Dead serious.
Wow.
Look my man up on the internet. Rudy Rangel, aka Cato.
Wow.
See, nigga, him alone responsible for at least 2,000 deaths in Chicago.
Damn.
You mean?
Shit. Rest in peace.
Yeah. Keep my nigga on my arm.
That's crazy,
four
man.
Four of us hit his door for life. Four of us. Me, him, Cato, and my nigga Peasy. We all got tattoos at the same time.
Damn.
I was like, yo, I just met the nigga, though. We came. Nobody introduced us. There was no dick rat shit. Yo, this is the headline king. Say what's up. This is DMX. We just was working in the same studio. The same studio. R. Kelly.
That's gangster.
So it's like, we see a nigga every day when you coming in.
Yeah, y'all just kicked it. It just happened.
Turns out to be the best of fucking friends.
Wow.
Best of friends, man. A lot of nigga, dog. You know what I mean? He showed me how the gang shit work. You know what I'm saying? He put me down on shit. Like, yo, this how, you know what I mean? I went to this hood and I sit in a restaurant and it was like the same niggas just walking by. The same group of two niggas, but it's like different niggas every time. But they all the same. Hoodie, when they go to hoodie, when they go to baseball cap, when they go to ballhead. You know what I mean?
Wow.
Walk around and they throw up the shit, you know what I'm saying? Little sign of it. He's like, man, man. So he knew.
Wow.
When you got beef with nigga, it don't matter who else know, as long as you know that nigga know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, nigga, you can front all day.
Shit.
But in your heart, you know you pussy, and you know I know I could have
took his life right there.
Your fucking life, man.
Yeah.
So you can front all you want, but next time you see me,
shit.
Bow down. It's gonna be a bow down.
Damn.
You know, nigga, I spared your fucking life. I mean, I spared your life, you fucking bitch. And when they hit my man, nigga,
wow.
Now my fucking hands in his fucking lap.
Damn.
My fucking haircut. He's supposed to go on the scene. You know what I'm saying? He put me onto the gang shit. I put him onto the remote control cars. I put him onto the quads, and the test that I ride him to my house out there, you know what I'm saying?
Damn.
My wife, fuck with his wife, you know what I'm saying? I fuck with him, you know what I'm saying? We had this wedding. I mean, it's like, we became...
Damn.